Tucked in or out, and I love layering like with the jewelry and a nice bag, and I love a jacket, you know that. So it was the best by miles. It's just amazing. It's not just your average glass. It's got an ever slight whitewash. It says Honoré Bear and back. Hi everyone, welcome back to another video. So let me talk about the order of this video. So you are now seeing me in the future from what you're about to see, which is good because we are going to have a little visit to Dr. Marwa in this video. And this is the result of part one of phase two. So I'll link the video below for you to see how I originally looked. I mean, it wasn't like a face transplant or anything, but it's been a really noticeable improvement. I was then meant to go back and like standard procedure, have a few little tweaks. I always get out of breath when I haven't filmed a video for a while because I get nervous and I don't know why, even though I'm just in my room. So it's normal procedure. There's a fly in here that I just can't get rid of. That you just go and have a little tweak from the Botox and the filler. I left it a bit longer just because I've just been so busy. And then I can't remember if there was some sort of problem with the rules. This fly is really distracting me. I hope you can't hear it, but I can't get rid of it. So anyway, left it a bit of a gap. And then I didn't want to do everything in one go, and neither did Dr. Marwa. So I'm then going back again to have my Botox top up and my second session of skin tightening, the laser. And then I'll probably have like a radiant facial. So I don't think I'll be able to put this all into this vlog because I really want to get it out. But stay tuned for the next vlog. If I can put it in this, I will. But stay tuned for the next vlog to see the final result. And then I'll be stopping. I'll just be going back for the tightening and the facials and Botox tweaks and fillers when I need it. But I'm happy with how things are. So this is the result. So my nose, I had a tiny, tiny bit put in my nose, like literally the tiniest amount. And then we tweaked the cheeks and like a smidgen in the chin. It was literally a smidgen. So that was used to be my bad side. My wedding photographer told me that back in 2015, and he kind of was right because it was the side that wasn't at all symmetrical. But now I don't mind being either side because I feel like I'm more even now. So I just always want to be transparent about that. Oh, I had a tiny, tiny bit more on my lips just to even them out as well, because my lips are naturally odd. That size is a lot smaller, which is quite common. But I had no Botox. So yeah, that is the result from Dr. Marwa, and you're going to see my visit with her next. My camera ran out of battery, so I didn't film too many things going in needle-wise. My jewellery, I think I also spoke about that. I'm wearing the same hoops that I've just been living in, wear this every day, whether I mix it with my fine jewellery or like the long necklaces, which I think you're going to see next. I've got this ring on, H for Honoré, and then I've got my C ring. Love this ring. I have a necklace as well, so I'll link all of these below as well. This is High Street, this is High Street-ish. And I'll link these below, and I have a discount code for these two as well. So we're going to talk about a little haul, and then we're probably, that's the probably, I don't want to keep it too long, but I just want to show you some amazing pieces. Everything here is from Farfetch. Farfetch is a brand that I've worked through for a long time, and I've been a customer and a shopper for even longer. Same reasons why I've stood loving Farfetch. It hasn't changed. They have the biggest selection of pieces, and that's because there's lots of boutiques. For those of you that don't know, there's Farfetch is compiled of many boutiques around the globe. So that means that there's more stock, there's more places to pull from, and because it is different countries, if something's a sellout here in Europe, it might not be in America. So that's what happened when I bought my Fendi dress. It was sold out everywhere here, and I managed to get it on a website on a store from America, but via Farfetch. So they're great for that. Always my go-to when anything's sold out, and they have the discount code, which terms and conditions apply in the description box below. But you can always guarantee that you'll find the like unusual things, and this is a really good example. So you might be watching this from a different country, or you might be watching this more in the future where this is more available, but right now, this was only available at Farfetch. I'm not sure if it's still the case now. I think it is. But you know I love play suits, especially, I've always loved them, but since being a mum, sorry to play the mum card, but it's so true, I'm constantly bending down and I'm finding myself wearing less dresses, and I love long dresses, but I still want to wear, sorry about that, my memory card got full, and I feel like that's always the universe telling me to stop talking, because it always happens when I'm talking too much. But going back to the play suit, yeah, cinches you in at the waist, gives you some shape, but it's comfy because it's elastic. And then I was just about to tell you that the belt is very cleverly attached to the play suit. So really small details, but actually makes this play suit amazing because it's cinched in, but comfy, has a belt that I'm not going to lose, has pockets, it's the right length. I recently shared a dress in my last haul that I felt was, everything was in the wrong place. It was very unflattering. I had some feedback saying that it was my body and not the dress, which I also admitted, it's definitely like didn't suit my body. But I also felt that design features about the dress for a dress that was that expensive should have had more thought going into like the pattern cutting, where the frills and pockets were placed. So this is the opposite. So when I do buy a dress or get gifted a dress, I will openly say if I don't think it's a good piece to buy, and I will openly tell you that. But this is the opposite, everything's in the right place, it's really flattering, and I've been living in these play suits, this and the other one. So I'll link, this comes in a couple of colors and you can get 10% off this as well. And I can't resist buying something from this brand every single summer because there's always something that I fall in love with, so you might as well snap one up now and use your 10%. That's one of my favorite pieces. But this is very, very me. So in a couple of hauls ago, you would have seen that I wore an Attico dress. I haven't actually had the chance to wear this, but there's gonna be so many places I can wear it. My Attico dress that I had, the gray one, I really regret buying, ordering the size medium, because it was too big. And it makes me look bigger than what I am, but I don't really care. It's really comfortable. It's a sweatshirt dress, I don't mind. I ended up not thinking and ordering this in the same size and thinking, oh, I've ordered it too big, but actually the sizing of this comes up completely different and it's my perfect size. So as always, I will put the link in the description box below, but then after the link, I will put which size I have and any size and advice, like this comes short, this comes long, this comes small. It will always be in the description box below. But this is one of my all-time favourite dresses. It's very flattering, although it's so simple and basic. I love the wide cuff sleeve. I just love that. It just adds a little bit something different to your average sweatshirt. And I love the curved skirt. It just really is flattering and elongating on the leg. And then the similar kind of design of the Zimmerman play suit, it has that cinched in stretch waist, so it gives you some shape, but it is so comfortable. There are so many different ways I would wear this. I would wear this out for the evening, I'd wear it for dinner, I'd wear it to an event, I'd wear it on holiday with flip-flops, I'd wear it in the city with trainers or biker boots. It's just one of those dresses that is so amazing and flattering and comfortable. It's stretchy sweatshirt, so it goes with most figures, I would say. And it's just an all-round great dress. And you might think, oh, it's just a sweatshirt dress, which someone commented in my last video. Someone said, oh, say sweatshirt dress one more time because it's actually a tongue twister. But there's a lot of design features that go into this that makes it so flattering, and that I think is the sleeves, the elastic at the back, and the curved skirt. So really love this. It comes in other colours as well, and again, you can get 10% off of this brand as well. But that's just one of these finds that I will wear forever, literally until my legs can take wearing a short skirt. I was really excited when I found this, and it looked even better on. I absolutely love it. And it's not too chunky like the grey one. It is different to the grey one. I can layer this more, so I do prefer this one. Still love the other one. Then I have some classic tees to show you, because I feel like that's one thing that I always get asked. I have so many of these t-shirts because they're amazing. They're both by the same brand, but completely different shape and style. This is fitted, this is oversized. It's just a really great brand. They wash up really, really well. Yep, they wash well. I would much prefer to spend a premium. I mean, not ridiculous, but I'd rather spend a premium on a tee that I can wash and wash and wash, and it comes up just the same as being brand new. And I like wearing nice quality t-shirts that feel nice. And these are amazing colours. I literally live, like you can see, I'm either wearing a sweatshirt or I'm wearing a t-shirt, and I keep it quite similar, and I love layering, like with the jewellery and a nice bag, and I love a jacket, you know that. But I wanted to introduce you to some t-shirts that I love, because I always get asked that. I do love a few brands of t-shirts, so I'll link some below, and I do love a logo tee, but if you're looking for a classic, good quality tee, they're not overly high price point, but it is a higher end brand, so it's more than your average price, but the shape is amazing. Like, this one has a bit of a capped flare sleeve, and then it's fitted, slightly fitted, and then goes out at the bottom, and then it has some embroidery here, so it's not just your average tee, and the colours are really amazing. So just a brand that I love when it comes to tees. And then this is another top that I love. This is a whole outfit that I've been wearing all of the time. So these are my new leggings. I've washed and worn these so many times, and take note of the size and advice for these, because I was quite surprised with the size, and I had like a gut feeling to not get my normal size, and I did that, and I was relieved that I picked the right size for once. I'm also going to link my other favourite leggings that I love that I've shown you in a previous haul. I'm just going to link them because it's something that I wear all of the time. I live in them. They're amazing. Sizes are a bit off, so I'm going to mention the sizes in there. And I want to mention them because of the discount code, because they're quite pricey for a legging, but they're absolutely amazing. And if you're ever going to buy them, if I'm talking about them on stories or something, I want you to buy them now than in a haul in a couple of weeks' time when I don't have the 10% discount code for you. So I'll link them below. But these are my new leggings. They are just your standard leggings. They have a zip at the bottom, so you can have them tie or flared over your trainer or your shoe. But they're just amazing leggings. They just slip up, no pockets, they're very thick, they're stretchy, they're so flattering. They're the type of leggings that you can wear out in an evening, wear them on a date, wear them to the office. They're an all-round legging, and they are the cheapest on the market that I've tried and tested. So they're amazing. If you're looking for a pair of black leggings slash trousers or some split leggings, split hem leggings, these are your one, and you get the 10% off them. So this is such an amazing item to show you, which I know is only a basic black legging, but literally just me in an outfit with one of my nice jackets. I keep my jackets for years and years, and I love how I could put like cream linen Jacquemus oversized blazer with this and a pair of sliders, or I could put an oversized knit or a leather jacket and a pair of New Balance trainers. I love how you just have your basics. I'm so into basics, but I'm not minimal, so I love how you completely change the look with some jewelry or a jacket. And like for me, the jacket is everything when it comes to styling. It completely changes the look. And then you can add a baseball cap. This is a really nice one that I like, a hessian one that I picked up on the high street. Like, look how that changes the outfit with like a biker over the shoulders and New Balance trainers. And then you can like put a nice fitted blazer on and a pair of like prada like heels or Manolo heels, and it's like a day to night outfit. So that's my kind of vibe. And this haul is very much my key pieces in my wardrobe. So I think that's what this haul's about, really. I never know until I'm actually talking about them. This is definitely key pieces. So although I'm only showing you tees and leggings, most of us do wear that every day. And I'm showing you nice quality ones that you can wear day to night. Few other pieces like the play suit, because that is just literally how I style myself and the pieces that I like in my wardrobe. I like basic things, and every now and again put a nice pretty dress or play suit, and then you've got my more basic dresses. So yeah, this is such a me haul. Probably over talking. Last item I want to show you is this. This is my second one of these because it is one of my favourite tops. It also comes in black, which I've ordered myself. It's just the most amazing top. I wear it all the time. It looks so great. if I want to wear something other than a basic tee and I want to add a little bit more depth to the layering, this is amazing. It looks so good, tied up and belted, tucked in where it's a lightweight fabric. And it's not metallic-y, but it's also not matte, so it's a really unusual fabric. This brand comes up very oversized. Again, all size and details will be linked below. It didn't really look that much on the website, but when I put it on, the way it flows over your trousers looks so good with the black leggings, looks so good with jeans, it looks good tucked in or out. Lovely shade of beige, just an all-round amazing staple piece to have in your wardrobe. So they're all the pieces I want to show you. Everything will be linked below. If I find these in other colours, I'll link them below. Discount code will have an expiry date, which will be linked below in the video, just in case you're watching this later than after I shared it. I will now leave you with my little trip to Dr. Marwa. My battery did run out, so if it ends suddenly, that would be why. But I don't know, hopefully I get to film me going back to Dr. Marwa and I can film the final stage. But all details will be linked below. I would love it if you were to subscribe and see me in the next video. So thank you for watching. I'm actually going to open these for you. You can see my outfit here as well. It's really nice weather today. So this is one of my favourite angles. And you can see the island units in. So let's go over there. Flooring has been covered up. So I'm going to show you the floor first. It's so dusty in here, that's why we have to keep going out every day. And I have itched my eyebrows so badly. I used so many strong creams, my eyebrows are literally falling out. I cannot believe it. They went the best they've ever been with the pregnancy. And now, I'm not joking, my eyebrows are literally falling out. And then every time I put product on them, it irritates my eczema even more. So I don't even know what to do. You can see my arms here. I'm not really stressed. It's like it on both sides. It's really painful. I'm not that stressed. It's just, you know, when you're doing houseworks, you know, we've all been there. It gets quite exhausting and draining and it is stressful. But, you know, that kind of stress. And it's been going on for a year now. And we work from home. We have the baby that's like we're trying to teach to crawl and walk on this everywhere. So I think that's just why it's all getting a bit much. But we're nearly there. And this is the first time that I felt like it's coming together. We are so over the moon with the floor. I'm trying to stand somewhere it's not drip dusty. Here by the window. We're over the moon with the floor. Went with parquet flooring. They've only got that little bit to do in there. They've done the hallway, they've done here. I'll show you some cutaways. It's not been cleaned or anything. We've not got any skirtings on. But I really want to show you how it looks for now. They were like the no-brainer for me. I felt like at first glance they were the best for so many reasons. Not just about the colours that they offer, but having dogs... and being clumsy and not want like we I want to like have, you know, run through the house with heels and not damage it. I do have one naughty dog, and we've tried all sorts, like the natural wood, we've tried man-made, and it all seems to stain or get damaged, and we've got so many samples, and the parquet flooring wood was the quality was unbelievable. It doesn't mark, it's like a layered oak, but it's engineered, so it's really durable. So it was the best by miles, and we're so happy. And I must say, their workmen they're some of the best we've come across. I don't know if I should say the guy, because sometimes like you're not meant to, but okay, fine, his name's Peter, and he's just the nicest guy ever. I drive 20 minutes to get him Starbucks every day, because I like him that much, and I just want him to be happy working. But so over the moon with it, so. You can see the contrast here with the island unit. I wanted something quite natural. We've got like a natural oak in the kitchen. So in the kitchen, it's the natural oak. I had the hallway done with the same chevron. And the living room I've kept just for budgets, because this was obviously such a huge space. But I think I'm just going to have to go with the lounge, because I love it that much. We've gone for a nice warm tone, trying to be as natural as possible. Yeah, so it's just like as near as possible to like a natural oak colour, but it is slightly stained. It's like a brown, well, you can see what it is. It's got an ever slight whitewash.
And we love it. We actually went all the way under the island unit as well. I'm going to talk you through that island because it's so amazing.
I haven't vlogged for so long. There's so much to catch up on. By the way, I've gone back to wearing my double hoops. A lot of people said, oh, Claire, I've never seen you with that. I've always had them. And the reason why I'm wearing them again, I can't really wear a lot of makeup. You can see I'm just so itchy. No foundation anymore. I've got the best bronzer on. I've been wearing it for about 6 months and I'm going to link it for you below. It's amazing. It is so, so good. I have spoken about it before. Not paid ad or anything. It's like it's very dense, but it's lightweight, which is amazing and hard to find. It's shimmery and bronzy, but no glitter. It's amazing. Trust me, you're going to want to have this one. I'll link it below. I've also got my favourite lipstick on because my lips are like irritated and dry, so I'll link that below. And then my hoops, I think earrings are just the best way to brighten up the face. And because I've got this big logo here, normally I go for like my big CC earrings, but you know, it's a conflict of interest, so I've gone more subtle. So I'll link them below. This is an oldie but goodie. I actually got this when I was pregnant and I bought it so big. It was so stupid of me, but you know, it's oversized. I love it. I've got it with a pair of shorts, just comfy for today. And then I'll be wearing some of the bits that I showed you in the haul. So we got past all of that. We spoke about my eczema, we spoke about my eyebrows, we spoke about my earrings. Told you about the flooring. I will leave the exact name to the floor that we had. Cannot recommend them enough. And flooring companies must have such a hard time because they're responsible for meeting all the deadlines because all of the other building work goes on the banking of that floor going down, and they have to kind of work around everybody else. So I actually really feel for flooring companies or anyone that deals with the floor. They've got it quite hard. So enough of me talking. Sorry, I just wanted to catch up because we haven't spoken for so long. I can't wait to show you the floor properly. We are so overjoyed with it. So there's been a change of plan. Obviously, we changed the colour of the kitchen, which was quite a big deal. So happy with that. Loved this plaster colour, but it's just not realistic. I've tried everyone before because this is the colour of my master bedroom in the flat. They just come out pink and they look great, but I don't want this extension to be pink. So we actually, the plaster really did let me down. I won't get into it. But yeah, he really let us down. We waited for him for 6 months and then he said it was going to be another 6 months and then he wouldn't let me pay the deposit. So yeah, he was really messing us around. And you know, it is what it is because I'm going to enjoy this plaster colour. So this will be like this probably for another 6 months whilst I just save. And I know that the flooring, it would be good to paint and plaster before, but it is what it is. I'm not stressed about it. I just see it that I get to enjoy this beautiful plaster colour for a bit longer. We're going to have the same colour in the lounge coming through into the extension so it flows. And I just decided that I didn't want all, I've never wanted all different colours, but I experimented, thought about it, don't want different colours. So I think it's pretty much going to be the whole colour, the same colour downstairs with a little bit something something going in the hallway. The kitchen will be white, so that'll be loft white by little green. I nearly said Philip green then. That would have been awkward. So you get the vibe. It's going to be like an off-white colour in here. It's not really off-white actually, so I'll just wait until I show you that. It was quite hard to match against this cray, we'll call it cray, kitchen colour, because anything that wasn't, if it's off-white, it just looks like it's the same but not the same, and you need more of a contrast. And I didn't want white, I didn't want a colour, so that has been actually quite challenging. But I think I really am talking too much, so let's just talk you through the island unit. So the countertops are going down 2 days before Honoré's birthday, but I'm so happy with this. So we've just got one cupboard here. I don't know if you're interested in this, but this is the configuration, and it took me so long to plan. So I'm just thinking maybe someone wants to do similar. We've got a cutlery drawer here, and the reason why I chose that is because it's not fully fitted and I don't want to break it, but you can push that back and then it's a whole cupboard. And the reason why I chose cutlery here is so that when we plate up, and this will be a table, as you've probably gathered, and it will be a round table.
The upholstery people told us last minute that they couldn't take on the job because they're too busy. So I have no idea who's going to do this upholstery. It's probably going to be like this for ages. We're going to have a round table here with our Timothy Oulton chairs, either the vintage Bianco in the distressed leather, which actually looks so nice with this because they're an off-white, or I have my shearling ones. I'm going to see which I prefer. So that will be, this will be our everyday seating area, looking out with this view. This here, that's a used to be a dog house. I think I may have told you that we're turning it into a gym, with like bifolding doors on the front. So it's going to be a really nice view. On this side, we have a drinks fridge going here, and it's going to have a door. We have this one, I think, has been fitted. Yeah, so you can see how easy it is. I'm having all my placemats here. So I really thought about how I want things to be practical. I never used to have like a proper designated place for my placemats. They just used to go in a big hole like this. So I love it that I can have a few coasters, placemats. Look at the rainbow reflection. That's from the canine precision glass of our Timothy Oulton. They reflect rainbows. It's just amazing. It's not just your average glass. Can you see? And there's this rainbow. I obviously know that glass and some make a prism rainbow, but there's something different about the canine precision. So yeah, that's, I just wanted this to be really somewhere where we plate up all of the, when we have dinner parties or invite guests. And I love that Handmade Kitchen did so many drawers because it's a lot more convenient than shelving, but we do have some shelving. This is our oak, it says Honoré Bear. It's just an oak tray that we can use. I can put it on here. You know, obviously it's a tray, you use it for so many things. If you do go with Handmade Kitchen, you get, this is an oak tray, and you get complimentary engraving of your choice if you just quote my name, and you also get £500 off your taps. We have a wine fridge, which I know so many people have, but we're really excited about it. And Paris found this one, which I thought was so unusual. I much prefer having these two little doors like that. I think it's really, really nice, and I liked the contrast of the white. So that's the island unit. We were going to have the worktop come out slightly and then put stools underneath, because we don't have the island unit in the kitchen, and obviously we want to, it's nice to sit in the kitchen when someone's cooking. But I've decided against it because I'm just so worried that people are going to lean and it will snap, and you'll know why when I show you the what material we picked. But I've got these footstools, I love them, and I'm just going to keep them here so that, you know, when someone's, well, I don't know why I'm saying someone, when Paris is cooking, I can sit here, or, you know, vice versa, we can put the high chair here. So we've decided not against the stools because we have a whole seating area here, we have sofas here, you know, we don't want to overdo it. The kitchen, I think you've pretty much seen everything. We've got our spice racks put in. I'm so excited to get this all full. We've got our Miele microwave in here. This is the coffee station. We've got the fridge in. We finally have a fridge. Yeah, the kitchen's all done. They need to paint. I painted all that myself. So much effort, and now I'm paying someone to redo it. Pantry's done. So we have our Miele appliances in here. We have a tumble dryer in here. And I'm not going to show you all what's behind there because I'm basically giving you a kitchen tour here. But this is the update. So, so happy with it. That's the perspective from here. And when you do see the kitchen reveal in a couple of weeks, obviously you can see how it's all going to come together. You'll see with the floor, you'll see with the worktops, all the lighting will be done, because the lighting will obviously create such an amazing mood. I'm not going to tell you if we've done like distressed mirrors. I love a distressed mirror at the back, whether it's the same worktop material, tiles, painting. I'll leave that for the reveal. So that's what it looks like from here. Oh, just walked into something. And I just love all these reflections. So happy with the island. I actually felt a bit weird when it went in because I felt like it was like a random island in our living room. But obviously the whole point is that this is an entertaining open living space. And then we have our like movie room with a fireplace. So Yeah, I actually can't believe we have an island junior. I've never had one before. And it just feels like a real adult house that's not mine. So I'm really happy with it. So I've showed you the island junior. I've showed you the floor. You can see the floor here. I did want to save this for the reveal because you can't see how beautiful it is. But look at this perspective. It's so beautiful. Let me try and... It's a bit overexposed. When Paris films it on his camera, it'll be so much better. But you walk in and you see that arch, that archway into the room, the arch windows, the beautiful chandelier, the beautiful chevron. Obviously, you can't see that, but I just am so happy with it. It's just so beautiful. I love it. Dogs are going crazy. So that's the house update. Hope you enjoyed the little haul at the beginning. We're going to pop out for some lunch now. Getting ready for the party, so I cannot wait for that. I've got my sister's wedding next weekend. Then we've got Honoré's first birthday. I've tried to make it as special as possible. I just feel like we're having a big catch-up here because I haven't spoken to you for ages. This is my outfit. This is sold out. Can't really link much, but I will do what I can. So comfy, warm but nice for the summer. This is my bag I'm just putting together. I'm just putting my other jewellery on as well. I've literally been wearing this every day. I will link that below as well. I love it. I've actually just ordered it in the silver with the silver chubby hoops. I'm just getting my bag ready. And off we go. And back.
Hello.
So I've come for a little tweak from my sister's wedding. I let you explain? You explain better than me.
So previously when Claire came in, it was her first time. So we did very small amounts in particular areas just to give her a little freshen up. She's back again so that we can do a couple more tweakments, a little bit of baby Botox and a little bit of filler just to lift and refresh her look. The idea really when we're using injectables is not to add too much in one go because your face basically it's in order to maintain very natural looking results we add little and often and until you get your desired outcome. So we're doing things very slowly so that A, people don't notice, B, your face
even though I'm telling you all.
Sorry?
Even though I'm telling everyone.
Yes. And B, your face, it all molds in together and it takes shape better. And also just to for you to know at which point you want to stop. So if
yeah,
you put
definitely.
Too much in, you might want to take out later. If you do it gradually, it's better to add slowly than to remove later on. So that's
okay.
The idea.
So I'm going to show you what I'm having today.